She's a tough cookie with a caustic wit. The first time I met her, I felt like a foolish freshman girl being flipped off by a worldly senior. She was Montmartre, and I was intimidated by her. This place presents story after story of mocking the status quo. In cabarets, artists poke fun at everyone, and fake political parties parade, shouting slogans, "No winter, vote yes, swimming pool, and sacre coeur." Salvador Dali and Picasso were regulars here. At Arlapine Agie in 1910, Picasso and his friends tied a paintbrush to the tail of Lolo the donkey. The resulting masterpiece, Sunset on the Adriatic Sea, by the artist Borinali, earned lavish praise from the critics at the Paris Salon, who did not know their braid about art created by an ass. I imagined myself loftily pointing out colors on Sunset on the Adriatic, for I babbled on about works of art, from the Venus de Milo to Renoir's Moulin de Beguette. Stories unmasking Bobos, bourgeois Bohemians, and a man who wreaked havoc walking through walls, of Sacré-Cœur's ceiling mosaic showing politicians surrounding Christ. Much more genuine is the tiny Saint-Pierre de Montmartre. Jung wrote that to confront a person with his shadow is to show him his true light. Montmartre knocked me down a peg or two, which opened up painful cracks between my persona and my true self. Everyone, even most clueless freshman girl, knows that's how the light gets in.